Hey everybody, it's the Musical Gamer again. Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker in HD. Welcome back to Windfall Island, everybody. It is a beautiful sunny day, and we've got some side questing to do while we're here. So, last time we actually got the Earth God's Lyric and the Wind God's Aria. So, we know what it is we need to do next. But since we went to the Forsaken Fortress, there's been some things that have changed here on the island. Namely, the people we can talk to and the side quests that we can do. No, I did not want to talk to you. I already took care of what you were involved with, good sir. We got this over here, though. Hey, you, come on, use your head. You can't just stand there like that. You're in my way, can't you move? Oops, that won't do. That won't do at all. Already I'm back to my old habits. I'm terribly sorry. Really, I am. Welcome to you, sir. This way to Windfall's outdoor shop, chock full of fun and happy products. Yeah, you sound real enthusiastic there. I think her name's Mila? Mila, I think? You might not recognize her because it was just a quick, show of her, and she was wearing something completely different, but she was one of the girls trapped in the Forsaken Fortress. There are three of them. Errol was one, Mila was another, and Maggie. Maggie and Mila have had a little bit of a life swap, though, but this is the real reason why we're over here. No, no, no. If you wish to speak to me, please, I must insist you do so at my reception counter. Rules are rules. Fine. Always freaking do that. Yes, yes, yes. You're the young master who purchased my sail. At last, with those funds, I have been able to open my stall. But I hate to say that my poor little stall is not an instant success. In fact, it is rather deserted, I'm afraid to say. I think this tragic turn of events is due to the fact that I don't have a wide enough lineup of products. For, if I am to be fully honest, I only have one product. To put it another way, I think my stall would do much better if only I could stock rare items that people can't get here in town. Yes, yes, this is what I need. Then I would make plenty of money. Not just plenty of money, it would be like taking candy from many rich babies. No, 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 not even that! By running a prosperous business, I can play my part to help this town develop and become a happy place. Yes, yes, that is the proper perspective. But dear me, if only I had a young partner to help me out. A real go-getter. Yes, yes, Master, now that I take a longer look at you, I see that you have a fine delivery bag, do you not? Dear me, it is a bag fit for a hero of delivery. I have a small request, and it requires the use of that bag. A request? Oh dear me, I knew it, young master. I knew you would understand my plight. It is a rather long-winded explanation, but please take the time to hear me out. My stall is a kind of general store that makes its money by obtaining rare products at inexpensive prices and then selling them. With a reasonable markup, of course. However, because I have so few products to sell, the shop remains rather deserted. I will sell anything. I'm a master of the sale. I just need to get some new products. Could you not seek out traveling merchants and negotiate supply contracts with them for me? No, no, no. Do not look so frightened. I say contracts, but it is just a word. You do not have to do anything very difficult. All I need for you to do is trade one of my products for a new product that the merchant has in stock. You see, among merchants, a trade is proof of a contract. That is to say, it is the merchant's oath. That is what we call it, yes, yes. Merchants that have sworn a merchant's oath will afterwards send their products to me. It is the way things work. So as you succeed in trading my product lineup will increase. Do you understand everything I've told you? Perfectly, Mr. Zanari. Yes, yes, young master, and you are now my new salesman. No, no, scratch that. Starting today, you and I are partners. Dear me, yes. I give to you my proof of contract. In other words, this is my merchant's oath. Take it with you, my young partner. Ta-da, we got a town flower. The first thing you need to do is take this to another traveling merchant and trade it for something, to build on the foundation of my merchant's oath. So as you trade the merchant you traded with, will send his products to my shop, thereby increasing my product line, which will make me quite happy. Alright, we get the idea. So that is that side quest. We have a little bit of a trading side quest. There are a couple of Goron merchants scattered throughout the Great Sea. This is the only time in the game where you actually see Gorons. There's three of them scattered throughout the Great Sea. Gatesy, the Great Sea. One at Bomb Island, one at Great Fish Isle, and one at Mother and Child Isles. So, we will be making stops to do this trading side quest. Which we'll do in a bit, but right now I still want to take care of some more things that can be found here on Windfall. Like this. I know I have over 20 of these things. Do I have... I have 38, so still not quite enough. But we're getting there.
Ma.
My dear, did you bring me joy pendants yet again? 38. Blah, 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 blah. She'll take 20. And here's what we get. The Cabana Deed. Dum-da-dum. You see, although I am but a mere teacher, I own my very own cabana in a tropical oasis down south. But lately, I haven't made use of it at all, so you can have it. So, we have a swinging bachelor pad now. Yeah, bachelor pad. Right, so we have that, and that is actually required for the plot of the game. Not even kidding, because inside the cabana is a shard of the Triforce. So, with that in mind, we gotta go do that eventually. But we got the deed now, so we took care of that. You can get something else from her if you bring her another 30 joy pendants, which I will be doing as soon as I get enough. I think I only have 18 now, so I gotta get 12 more. Hello, hello! You there! Halt! Oh, you're just some wretched street urchin. I thought you were the postman. Be thankful, because if you were the postman, I would have shooed you out of here before you could say boo. But say, you look rather familiar for a street urchin. Have we perhaps met before someplace? If you don't recognize this guy, he's the poor old beggar man who was begging for us to go rescue his daughter. Now look at him. What? Whatever do you mean? You don't mean my daughter, do you? Because my daughter has already been rescued from the Forsaken Fortress. Why, she even returned with a huge load of lovely, glittering, delicious treasure. Thanks to her little incident, we've become filthy rich overnight. And I mean filthy. Why, there isn't a girl in the world who's as good child as my Maggie. You may not have been able to help me, but there's no harm done. I'm sure you'll accomplish something in life. Someday. In the meanwhile, my daughter has blossomed into quite the little beauty. Run along, go spend some time with her. Jesus, he's a friggin' weird old man. But the game doesn't explicitly tell you this right away. But if you show him some skull necklaces... This is one of those skull necklaces that my daughter Maggie brought back from the Forsaken Fortress. These sell quite well at antique shops. In fact, it was thanks to these beauties that I became so filthy rich overnight. Yeah, we can sell 20 of them for him, and he'll give us a gift. So, we actually literally only need to get one more. So, bearing that in mind, we'll do that as soon as we can. Oh, to think that I would survive my ordeal and return to this town. To think that I would ever be able to live in such a beautiful, opulent house. It's like a dream come true. But no, it's a nightmare. Without him by my side, it's like a rainstorm rages in my heart. What? Mo the Moblin. Oh, you've gotta be kidding me. You seriously have to be joking. A request? Could you take the letter I've just finished inking and deliver it to the postbox for me? Please, I beg of you. Well, sure. Hey, we know how to handle mail. We've worked as a part-timer at the Riddo Post, the post office. So, we'll just go take care of that. The postbox, don't you dare forget, but you must promise not to read it. The secrets of a girl's heart are to be shared only when she so desires. Well, okay, we won't read it. You'd do best not to read it. Actually, to be completely honest, I don't know if anything happens if you do try to read it, or if you can even read it to begin with, but just to be on the safe side, I'm not gonna read it. Whee! Okay, let's stick that right in here. No, not a knight's crest. Damn it, delivery bag. And here's a letter for you. And postage is only 5 rupees. Totally okay and within my budget. So, there. That takes care of that. I think we can continue this by just going right back to see her. So, is there anything else I want to do real quick? There is another thing you can do. I'm wondering if we can do this now. Well, I'm thinking about it. If we talk to Lenzo... Guess what, youngling? Today is a great day in pictography. Yes. Okay, so we can do this. Legendary pictographs. It's an image of a being or essence that has passed beyond the knowledge of this world. They're quite incredible, really. These are images that one comes across only in the rarest of circumstances, but as I am the leading pictographer in the land, I have managed to gather many of them. So, we gotta give him a... Oh, we gotta give him our deluxe picto box. Can't speak. It's early, so sue me. But of course, we need to pay. 150 rupees. Zip! Penniless ragamuffin. that is how you get some certain pictographs in order to get some figurines at the Nintendo Gallery, whatever it is. Since I'm not doing the side quest, I'm not going to bother doing it, but you can get pictographs like of a great fairy, the King of Hyrule, I think you can get one of Ganondorf, a couple of people and beings that you cannot get a picture of throughout the course of the regular game. So, yeah, I mean, you can also get a pictograph of, Jaboon, I think. Yeah, I think you get a pictograph of Jaboon. Because you can get a pictograph of Valoo or, the Deku Tree. But Jaboon, no, because Jaboon only appears in a cutscene. Oh, what was I doing? I wanted to be up there. God damn it, me. Gotta go talk to Maggie again. Come on. Back up the stairs and back into this really, really swanky house. I'd love to live in a house like this. Are you kidding me? It's, like, friggin' amazing. Ah, yes. Here we go. Honestly, you just don't understand, do you? Open up your ears. Silence! I'm telling you, we don't allow postmen here. Be gone! Be gone! Don't be ridiculous. I went through great trials and tribulations to go all the way to the Forsaken Fortress and return with Mo's letter. Silence! Begone! Begone! Then please, be reasonable. Can you at least sign for the letter? Stay away from the summoner! I mean, silence! Begone! Begone! Just acknowledge I was here! Silence! Begone! Begone! Oh god, the last thing you want to do is piss off a Riddo postman. You probably know the guy, too. Well, what a wretched, unruly postman. I don't know anything about any Mr. Mo in any Forsaken Fortress. And yet he always comes here bringing his letters. Does this Mo think I'll let him lay a hand on my one and only daughter, Maggie? I don't care whose letters they are, they'll never reach her on my watch. Jeez. Well, unfortunately, that happened. We gotta go find the postman. And luckily, I know just where he is. He happens to be right in here. I think. Oh, please tell me I'm right. Ah, yes, good. Oh, it's you. I'm sorry you had to witness me fly off the handle like that over Maggie's house. I'm most embarrassed. That man just... Never mind. To tell you the truth, though, I came to deliver a letter addressed to Maggie from a moblin named Mo. But, as you saw, the girl's stubborn father won't permit me to give it to her. What a stubborn, meddling old man. Refusing to accept letters from the postman? Who's ever heard of such nonsense? I went to great trouble to go all the way to the Forsaken Fortress, and it was a most frightening ordeal, let me tell you. If I don't deliver this letter, then I'm a failure of the delivery trade. But I have other deliveries waiting to be made. I can't mope here forever. Actually, though, I have an idea. That old fool may not permit postmen on his premises, but surely he would allow you in the place, would he not? Could you deliver this letter to Maggie in my stead? What do you say? Yep, I'll do it. I'm kinda used to being a delivery boy at this point. Yep, we'll take care of that. No problem. Yep, as soon as I can get down the stairs. We can talk to this guy too. See the small metal pedestals around town? We call those Joy Pedestals. Yeah, they got installed a little while ago by the newly formed Joyous Volunteer Association. It's part of this grand plan to help decorate the town. Anyway, they're brilliant. I may as well tell you that both myself and Zunari, the guy who runs the stall over there, are members. You just have to be a part of stuff like this. Keep that in mind for later. If you remember, that town flower we got from Zunari actually has, kind of a ribbed little thing on the bottom. You can put those things in the pedestals around town. So those things are useful for two side quests, not just one, but two. So as soon as we actually get more done with the training side quest, we'll take care of that one too. Trudy do la 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 la. I can't even right now. Here, take your stupid letter. Is that, could it be? The letter from Mo I saw in my dreams? Let me read it this instant. This is Mo. I like you, Maggie, so much that I want to eat you for dinner. Did you hear that? Those words? This means, I mean, it must mean, can it? Is this his marriage proposal? This game. Oh, this game. Trudy doody doo la la. What the hell is going on? I don't even know. But we get a piece of heart. Treasure it always. I don't even know. No, don't hit her with a sword. But that takes care of that side quest, and we get a piece of heart. Oh, Jesus. I really don't even have words for what happened there. Next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker in HD, we'll take care of more side quests, but ones that can only be done here at night. This is the Musical Gamer signing off. See you guys next video.